Hi and namaste. I wanted to make this video about my experiences with Ayurvedic medicine. It's the first time I've ever explored that route of medicine. Like most people in the UK, I've been used to the more traditional Western medicines, and so I've taken for granted the kind of treatments that are prescribed by Western doctors, and I've never thought much about anything else really. I've just taken for granted that's the way to do things. However, I think the COVID situation has led a lot of us to start reconsidering the kind of medical treatments that we've taken for granted in the West over the years. In particular, the type of things that we perhaps put into our body and other aspects of the way Western medicine approaches cures. It tends to, I think, focus upon treating symptoms rather than dealing with causes. And that's one of the things that started attracting me to Ayurveda. Now, what specifically made me go and consult an Ayurvedic doctor was an injury in this right wrist, in particular in the thumb. It's a thing called the Quervain's syndrome. It's basically a bit like carpal tunnel syndrome, where the tendons that help your thumb to rotate and move are inflamed, and in the sheath where they pass through in this part of your wrist here, you can get some quite severe pain, which is what I started experiencing back in November of 2020, which at the time of making this video is 7 months ago. Now, basically, this problem in my wrist developed for, I'm not quite sure why it just developed, and it was incredibly painful, and it had the effect of really limiting what I could and couldn't do with my right hand. For example, I couldn't even chop fruit and carrots and vegetables and things like that. It just hurt too much. So I basically took some medical advice on this, and the approach seemed to be to take hand exercises, and if those didn't work, you were looking at an injection of steroids. And I really didn't fancy the idea of injecting chemicals into my wrist, especially as reading more widely, I found that didn't necessarily cure the situation fully. So I talked to my wife about it, and she basically said, well, I think you should be looking at Ayurvedic treatment. And in fact, for some other things as well, which I'll talk about in another video. I'll concentrate on the wrist issue in this video. I thought, well, she's right. So she found an Ayurvedic practice in the part of London where we live. And I went for a consultation in April, having been suffering with this flipping wrist for, by that stage, nearly 5 months, and it just not getting any better. The exercises were making no difference. I was having to wear a splint all the time. It really made no difference. So I went along to see the Ayurvedic doctor, Dr. Rishi, at the Pranava Kerala Ayurvedic Centre on the Kenton Road in West London. And Dr. Rishi asked me to explain the symptoms, which I did, and he recommended that I should have a course of Ayurvedic massage at the centre once a week, every week for 4 weeks. And as part of the treatment, there would be massaging oils and a thing he called a potli, which I'd not heard of before. So I booked my treatment sessions, and a week later went for my first Ayurvedic massage, where I met the amazing Bharat, who has carried out the series of treatment. Now, basically what happened was, don't forget, Ayurveda is a holistic approach. So I wasn't surprised to find that the treatment started with a massage from the lower back, working the way up to the shoulders, the neck, and only then started to work down the arm, and then following the root of the tendons along the arm. And so nearly half of the treatment was working towards the area in question. And then about the other half of the treatment was focusing on this area in the wrist. And the massage involved these wonderful sweet smelling oils, which were warm, in fact, quite hot. Nice ambient lighting, beautiful Vedic music playing. The whole experience was really quite spiritual, actually. In fact, it was quite a, you found yourself going into quite a meditative state while the massage was happening. And then towards the end, Bharat started applying the potlis, which are like muslin sacks. I've got some photographs of them, which I'll include in the video. And they're dipped into the hot oil, and he sort of pats them and then smooths this hot oil and presses the potli into the injured area. Well, I found this whole experience really, really positive. I thoroughly enjoyed it. It was fantastic. And I came out, I'd cycled to the centre because basically in West London, driving is a waste of time. The fastest way you can get around is by bike. And so I'd cycled there, and cycling had been quite painful prior to this. Well, I noticed straight away, after just one massage session of 50 minutes, that already my wrist had got more movement, a bit more strength back, but also that I was feeling better generally. I'll come on to that in a minute. So it was quite clear by the time I got home that this wrist felt an awful lot better for the first time in 5 months. And I was really surprised by that. And I thought, well, that'll wear off after a couple of days, but it didn't. By the time I went for my next massage a week later, I was still feeling the benefits of that first massage. And the second massage built on the first one. Same thing, 50 minutes of massage from the back, down the arm, the application of the potli. And as I came out of the second one, I could feel that the wrist was even more fluid in its movement, the pain was reducing. And after the second one, I was able to start chopping things again, something I'd not been able to do. I could chop things with a knife for the first time for 5 months. And the feeling of well-being was coming back. It was like sort of internal energies were being regenerated. It was quite incredible. And my back had got more movement and was pain-free, much more pain-free. So I went for the third session and Bharat introduced a neck massage. Now, I had a neck injury when I was about 22 in one of my dad's racing cars where he did a racing start. I didn't brace myself properly and I cricked my neck. I've had a click in my neck movement ever since my early 20s. Just one massage with using Ayurvedic oils, and that's gone, and I've got completely free neck movement for the first time since my early 20s, which is incredible. Anyway, I came to the end of the four sessions and things were vastly improved. Not just the wrist, my general well-being, everything just felt better, more energized, more positive. So I booked some further sessions, but on a fortnightly basis. And to cut a long story short, I've had another four sessions. And this wrist now is almost back to completely normal. And it's all been done with massage and oils. And not only that, I feel a whole lot better. I can touch my toes when I bend over. I can touch my toes for the first time in my life. I've always been pretty stiff, not been able to do that. I can do that again now. Just so much has changed as a result of this Ayurvedic treatment. In fact, I'm so impressed with the treatment I've received that I'm going to have a once every 3 weeks, once every 4 week Ayurvedic massage permanently. I'm going to do this forever because it's just made such a difference. So I just wanted to share my experiences with you because they've been so positive. And say to anyone out there who's suffering from aches and pains or, you know, poor energy levels, check out and see if you've got an Ayurvedic centre near you, because you may be really surprised at the difference it can make. So I hope that's been helpful and interesting to those who aren't familiar with Ayurveda. I'm sure those who are familiar with Ayurveda won't be in the slightest bit surprised with what I've shared here. Anyway, see you in a future video. Namaste.